My name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team, and I would like to discuss with you a few tips and tricks to improve your experience working with Interpart modeling in assemblies in NX. Today we will be looking at a couple different approaches to adding a tray at the bottom of this coffee machine. The first thing that we will explore is creating a non-associative link while using drag and drop geometry. I am beginning here by opening a new window, which is a blank part in the assembly. By making this my active part, all changes and additions will appear on this level of the assembly. I'm going to utilize the selection filter to more easily select faces and then select drag and drop between windows. What this does is it allows for geometry from one part to be selected and used to create geometry in a new window. Notice now that the pattern from the right window at the bottom of the coffee maker mirrors that of the geometry on the left. This is extremely useful in simplifying clutter on larger assemblies and projects. As I make changes to the part in the right window, these changes are dynamically updated and reflected in the left window. As you can see, this simple tray has already been completed to fit this coffee maker. The other interpart modeling capability I'm going to explore today is associative interpart geometry. This means that when a previous feature or curve is edited, the new geometry will adapt to this change to reflect it. I will start once again with this same coffee maker and will once again be creating a tray to sit along the bottom. This time, however, I will use only one window, and these changes will be able to dynamically update with the changes of previous parts. One important item to pay attention to is this button here that says Allow Automatic Work Part Change. When this is selected, the work part will automatically change if a feature is selected outside of the current work part. By deselecting this tool, users are able to select features and geometry from other parts without changing the active work part. One other key item in creating associative interpart geometry is selecting the Create Interpart Link tool. This allows geometry to be linked to parts outside of the work part. At first glance, this extrusion appears to present an identical solution to that of the first strategy we used today. However, when the geometry of previous parts is altered, this new extrude can now reflect these changes. To check this, I'm going to alter the front face of the coffee maker using the Move Face tool. There will not be an immediate link from the associative geometry because there is an automatic timestamp. This is done to avoid unintentional changes due to editing of previous parts. As expected, when I complete this change, there is a gap between the tray and the front of the coffee maker. As mentioned before, this is an associative link, which means our extrude will match this cutaway. To do this, I must go into the part I created the extrusion on and enter the part navigator. When I click on the linked composite curve, you can see the timestamp selection towards the bottom. By unchecking this box, the extrude will automatically update to match the new bottom that was created by the move face. These tools are very beneficial as they make changes in large assemblies quick and efficient. To recap what we have looked at, we began using a non-associative link between assembly geometry. In doing so, we looked at how to use drag and drop between windows. After this, we looked at associative interpart geometry and the importance of timestamps. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.